Hello children, welcome to biology class. Today we are starting a new chapter, that is chapter 2, sexual reproduction and flowering plants. Children, we know that flowers are the reproductive organs of a plant, isn't it? Much more before the actual flower is seen on a plant, the decision that the plant is going to flower has taken place. Several hormonal and structural changes are initiated which lead to the differentiation and further development of the floral primordium. Okay, floral primordium, and the inflorescences are formed which bear the floral buds and then the flowers. So in the flower, the male and female reproductive structures, the andrecium and the gynoecium, differentiate and develops. Okay. So, I will show you a diagrammatic representation of a typical flower. Okay, see children, this is sepal or calyx. These are petals or, corolla. And here you can see anther. Isn't it anther? Andrecium, the male reproductive structure, and this is pistil, gynoecium, the female reproductive structure. Okay, children? So, this is a typical flower. See, this is structure of stamen, anther and filament is there. Collectively, we can call it as male reproductive structure, andrecium. This is pistil or carpel. It consists of stigma, long style and ovary. Stigma, style and ovary. Male and reproductive structure. Structure of stamen. See, these are male reproductive structures. See. Okay. Then structure of carpel. This is carpel. Okay, children, clear? Now, let's learn about stamen, microsporangium and pollen grain. Okay, so children, we know that the diagram is there in our textbook too and shows two parts of a typical stamen. Which are the two parts of a typical stamen, children? Yeah, this anther and filament, isn't it? The long slender stalk, this long slender stalk called filament, and the terminal germinally bilobed structure. This is terminally bilobed structure called anther. The proximal end of the filament is attached to the thalamus or the petal of the flower. The number and length of stamen are variable in flowers of different species. Okay. And a typical angiosperm anther is bilobed with each lobe having two theca. That's why it is known as dithecus. Okay. So often a longitudinal groove runs lengthwise separating the theca. Okay, so the bilobed nature of an anther is very distinct in the transverse section of the anther. So here you can see transverse section. This is TS of anther. See, if you take a transverse section through the anther, we will get a structure like this. It looks like a butterfly, right? So the anther is four-sided, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4. The anther is four-sided, tetragonal structure, isn't it? Consisting of four microsporangia. So, one microsporangia here, second one, third one and fourth one. So, transverse section of anther shows four microsporangia. Is it clear? These four microsporangia located at the corners and two in each lobe. That means in one lobe, two microsporangia. In another lobe, this is second lobe, isn't it? Here also two microsporangia. So in total, how many microsporangia are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Children, in singular, it is called microsporangium. Its plural form is microsporangia. Okay. Then this microsporangia develops further and become pollen sac. Okay, they extend longitudinally all through the length of an anther and are packed with pollen grains. We know that the male gametes are pollen grains. Okay, children, the same diagram is there in our textbook. What is this? This is structure of microsporangium. So this is the transverse section, isn't it? TS. So in transverse section, a typical microsporangium, see this is a microsporangium, it is appears circular. Okay, it is circular in outline and it is followed by four wall layers. See, the first layer, second layer, the third layer and the fourth layer. And here inside you can see the microsporangium. So which are these four layers and what are their functions? Huh? The first layer is epidermis. Okay, and it is followed by endothecium. And the third layer is middle layer. And the fourth one is tapetum. Okay, so you repeat with me. The first layer is epidermis, second one endothecium, third one middle layer, and the last one is tapetum. Okay, the outer three wall layers perform the function of protection and helps in dehiscence of anther to release the pollen. Which are the outer three layers? Epidermis, endothecium, middle layer. Which are their what are their functions? They are protective in function and helps for dehiscence of anther. That means release. That means the breakdown of anther for the release of pollen grains. Okay. And the last layer, tapetum. See, this is the last layer, tapetum. And the tapetum nourishes the developing pollen grains. As we all know, inside there is porogenous tissue. From this part, the gametes will develop. So, for the development of these gametes, tapetum provide nourishments. Clear, children? Okay. So, when the anther is young, a group of compactly arranged homogeneous cells called the sporogenous tissue occupies the center of microsporangium. So, this is single microsporangium inside being young. A group of compactly arranged homogeneous cells called sporogenous tissue arranged in the center. And it is covered by four wall layers. Is it clear? The structure of microsporangium. Okay, now let's discuss, see again the structure. This is epidermis, endothecium, middle layer, then this is tapetum. And what is this? The innermost microsporangium. It is having, being young, this anther is having sporogenous tissue. So that's about the structure of microsporangium. Now we are going to study the process. That is microsporogenesis. As the anther develops, the cells of sporogenous tissue undergo meiotic division, meiosis. For what? To form microspore tetrad, isn't it? So we know that meiosis is reductional division for the development of gametes. Which is cell division? Yes, meiosis. So, each cells of sporogenous tissue is capable of giving rise to microspore tetrad, isn't it? That means pollen. Each one is potential pollen or microspore mother cell. So, the process of formation of microspores from the pollen mother cell through meiosis called microsporogenesis. Okay. So, see the formed tetrads. These are microspore tetrads. Can you see the structure? These are microscopic views. Okay. So the microspores, as they are formed, are arranged in a cluster of four cells. That is microspore tetrad. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see four cells here. Okay. So as the anther matures and dehydrate, the microspores dissociate from each other and develop into the pollen grains. So, inside each microsporangium, several thousands of microspores or pollen grains are formed that are released with the dehiscence of anther. Okay, children. Now, let's discuss the structure of pollen grain. So, the same diagram is there in our textbook. The pollen grain. The pollen grains represent the male gametophyte. You children, if you touch and open the anthers of hibiscus or any other flower, You would find a deposition of yellowish powdery pollen grains in fingers, isn't it? So these are pollen grains. You just sprinkle it on microscope and observe through, sprinkle it on a glass slide and observe through microscope. Okay. So once we get a chance to enter schools, we are having an important practical work, that is pollen tube elongation. Okay. So during that time, you can observe pollen grains of different flowers. Okay. So see, now let's discuss the structure, the stages of a microspore, which how the pollen grains are formed from microspore, tetrad, okay. So the stages we are going to explain now. Pollen grains are generally spherical, see, they are spherical, measuring about 25 to 50 micrometers in diameter. It has a prominent two-layered wall, okay, two walls. Which are the two walls? Outer exine, E-X-I-N-E, outer exine, and inner intine, intine, I-N-I-T-I-N-E, intine, okay. So the hard outer layer called exine, it is made up of a tough organic material, that is sporopollenin, S-P-O-R-O-P-O-L-L-E-N-I-N. Children, which is one of the most resistant organic material known. It can withstand high temperatures and strong acids and alkalis. No enzymes that degrade sporopollenin are so far known. Okay, so pollen grain exine has prominent aperture called germ pore where the sporopollenin is absent. Okay. So, pollen grains are well preserved as fossils because of the presence of this sporopollenin. Okay, the exine exhibit a fascinating array of patterns and designs. Clear? So, that is about the outer wall layer, exine. Next is intine, I-N-T-I-N-E, intine. Okay, that is intine, that is the inner wall layer. It is thin and continuous layer made up of cellulose and pectin. Okay. The cytoplasm of pollen grain is surrounded by a plasma membrane. When the pollen grain is mature, it contains two cells. Which are the two cells? A vegetative cell. See, this is vegetative cell and it is followed by generative cell. Okay. A vegetative cell and generative cell. Clear, children? The vegetative cell, the first one, it is bigger, has abundant food reserve, and a large irregularly shaped nucleus. See, irregularly shaped is nucleus in vegetative cell. Clear? Whereas the generative cell is small and floats in the cytoplasm of the vegetative cell. It is spindle shaped with dense cytoplasm and a nucleus. In over 60% of angiosperms, pollen grains are two cell stage. In remaining species, the generative cell again divide mitotically to give rise to two male gametes before pollen grains are shed. So, in 40% of angiosperms, it is in three celled stage. Okay, is it clear? So, that's about the structure of pollen grain. Generative cell and vegetative cell and generative cell. See, different pollen grains, different sized and different shaped pollen grains. Children, pollen grains of many species cause severe allergies and bronchial infections. Okay. And it leads to different types of chronic respiratory disorders, asthma, bronchitis, etc. It may be mentioned in parthenium or carrot grass that came into India as a contaminant with imported wheat and has become an important pollen allergy. Okay. Another structure of pollen grain, here exine and intine is, you can see exine and intine, the outer wall layer which is made up of sporopollenin, and it is absent at the germinal pore through which the pollen tube elongates during the time of fertilization. Okay. And the inner wall layer is intine. And which is this cell, children? Yes, vegetative cell, and the small one is generative cell. Again, the structure in a single slide. See, this is microsporangium. Here, the sporogenous tissues are there. They will divide meiotically. The pollen mother cell divide meiotically and produce microspore tetrad. They separate and pollen grains released. Clear, children? And see, during the time of ruptures or when it get matured, what happens? The water content and the wall layers will released and it will breaks here. This process is known as dehiscence of anther, and through this dehisced anther, the matured pollen grains will release out. Okay. Then pollen grains are rich in nutrients. It has become a fashion in recent years to use pollen tablets as food supplements. Children, in Western countries, a large number of pollen products in the form of tablets and syrups are available in the market. Okay, so pollen consumption has been claimed to increase the performance of athletes and race horses. Okay, so that is about stamen microsporangium. Then in rice wheat, it takes 30 minutes for the release, for their release. And in some members of Rosaceae, Leguminaceae and Solanaceae, they maintain viability for months. Okay. Again, a diagram of dehisced anther. So that's about today's class. Today we discuss the process of formation of male gamete pollen grain. It is called microsporogenesis. If the question is asked for 1 mark, how you will answer? What is microsporogenesis? The process of formation of microspore from pollen mother cell, PMC, through meiosis. It is called microsporogenesis. Okay. So, thank you, children. You read the textbook thoroughly and draw each and every diagram to your notebook. Okay. So, the diagrams you have to draw are on page number 20, figure 2.1. Then, on page number 22, figure 2.3a and b. Then page number 25, figure 2.5a. These diagrams, you should copy these diagrams to your notebook. Okay, study well, children.